Hi guys, welcome to another web development tutorial. I am Josef Botner. In this video tutorial, I'm going to talk about formatting text in HTML5. There are a lot of elements for formatting text in HTML5. One of them are bold and strong tags, which are used to bold text. I'm going to use first this tag B, which will make text to be bold. I'm going to place this text with Ctrl X and paste here inside this B tag. As you can see, now this text is bold. Yeah. Another tag what you can use to bold a text is strong tag, which actually is doing the same thing as a B tag. Maybe you are wondering, let's put this underneath using this BR tag. Yeah, okay. Now you can see these two text, which I use this B tag and a strong tag. The both are bolded, as you can see. So actually the both tags, either B or strong, are doing the thing, the same thing. Maybe you are wondering why we need two tags for the same thing. An idea could be that the strong tag is encouraged to use in HTML5. Another idea could be that inside your HTML5 code, you while you're gonna to use this strong tag, you have the meaning that those text has bigger importance inside your HTML code. To advertise text is used this I tag. If you go over here on web page, you can see how this text was advertised, was written as italic text. As well, for the same thing, you can use M tag, which is doing the same thing. We write a text as italic, or we'll advertise as italic text. As you can see here, so these two texts are written now as italic because I use these two tags, I and M tag. The same thing, maybe you are wondering why we are using two tags for the same thing. In HTML5, it is encouraged to use this M tag instead of I tag to write italic text. Let's go further. If you want to underline text, you can use this ins tag, from which is a short from insert. Yeah, and as you can see here, this text was underlined. Let's put on another line the rest of the text. Yeah, and now you, if you have a look here on the web page, this text was underlined because I used this ins tag. As well, in HTML4, it was used this u tag to underline a text. As you can see, this u tag is doing the same thing like this ins tag. We'll underline a text. But in HTML5, it's encouraged to use this ins tag instead of this u tag, which was used in HTML4. If you want to superscript a text, you can use this tag, sup. Yeah. For example, I'm going to cut and paste here this text and another text. Let's write super script now, and here I'm going to put again this br tag. Let's arrange my code a bit here. Okay, and you can see here this superscript text went up higher in the air than this text, as you can see, because I placed this text superscript between these two tags sub, which makes a text to be a superscript. If you want to subscript a text, you're going to use a sub tag in this way. And if you have a look over here, you can see how this text went down below here, because I used this sub tag. As well, I'm going to use this br self-closing tag. Okay. This subscript tag can be used very useful in mathematical writing. For example, if I'm going to write here this x squared, and let's write here again this br tag, which makes the text which follows this x2 to go underneath on the other line. If I want this figure 2 to go down here, I can do this using this sub tag. I'm going to cut the 2 and paste it inside the sub tags. And here you go. Sorry, I used by mistake the sub tag, which makes this figure to go up here in the air. But you have an example how you can use mathematical this x by power 2. And the same thing, if you want this 2 figure to go below, you can use the sub tag. And let's place this 2 figure inside this tag's sub, and you can see now this 2 went down here. So as you can see, you can use very easy this sub and this sub and sub tags for the mathematical writing. Another formatting tags are, for example, del, which makes a text to be crossed by a line. And as you can see, this text was crossed by a line. As well, in HTML 4, it was used this tag strike, which is doing the same thing like this tag del. We'll cross a text by a line. As you can see, the both are doing the same thing. And if you want to separate your sections inside a web page, you can use this HR self-closing tag, which will insert a line, as you can see here on web page. If you have a look here over on this web page, you can see how this HR tag insert a line, and you can separate your section on your web page. Maybe you have seen this under this form with this backslash. As you can see, HTML5 tolerate this tag under this form, so this line staying here on this web page. Even I add this backslash. This way to use this HR tag is used in XHTML, but as I told you, HTML5 tolerate under this way to use this HR element, but in HTML5 is encouraged to use in this way, this HR tag. Yeah, so I can place here as well. Let's copy this. Yeah, insert here a HR tag as well here. Again here, and as you can see how this HR tag separate each section on my web page. I don't need here this, maybe here another one. That was all for today regard to formatting elements in HTML5. Hopefully this tutorial will help you. Thank you for watching this video tutorial. I'm waiting for you to watch my other video tutorials. See you next time. Bye bye.